Yeah, well, they're obviously the experts, so that's good.
Yeah. If you don't mind, Senator, I mean, could you just talk about, just kind of from the beginning, why was it important to you to sponsor this bill to increase the quality and access to quality childcare?
Yeah, well, I mean, I think a lot of, well, at least for me personally, I mean, a lot of the legislation that, you know, I've put in, you know, I've had some connection to it, you know, something in personal background that, you know, makes me understand or have more of an understanding. And certainly with, you know, I have two sons and my younger son, you know, we were blessed to have childcare through the CAP agency here in Hearst County, but it was hired. I still get emotional thinking about it. And it just makes a big deal for, you know, families. And for me, we know for a long time that we were falling behind on quality, affordable childcare. I mean, I hear it from constituents all the time. Certainly from my caucus members, you know, heard it across the state. And the pandemic exacerbated that big time. You know, people that were required to continue working were considered essential. Childcare facilities had, you know, closed for obviously good reasons. I mean, during the pandemic, we couldn't find places, and we had a problem before that. And so coming into this session, you know, I had a similar bill in the 129th pre-pandemic that got stopped because of the pandemic. But coming into the pandemic, it was a priority for me and my caucus to do more on childcare. And you know, I had toured the site in Waterville and was just like very, very impressed. And this model, this EduCare model, you know, doesn't just bring more childcare slots in. It also does more training for the staff people. It also gives more money to staff people. I mean, we can't just create slots and say we're done. We have to pay the people that are doing this, you know, incredibly important work, commensurate with what we think of it as being essential or, you know, valuable. And so this EduCare model, you know, does that. And, you know, we got to raise the standard for the workers. We got to create more slots across the state. We got to make sure that the children that are going there are being taught, you know, quality education. I mean, it's not just a place for them to sit and you know, spend their time while the parents are working. It's a place to get a head start, a boost, you know, and learn and grow. And so that's why, you know, it was really important. Like I said, we don't have enough. We depend on people in this economy in Maine to be out in the workforce. You know, most of the families today, traditionally, you know, both parents have to work, and childcare is just more important than ever. And I want to be clear too that, you know, what we've done here, it's just a start. I mean, I don't see this at all as like we've solved it. We need to do more than this too. But, you know, after 3 years of not all as easy debate on this, you know, we finally got a crack to where we're going to do more. And I just see this as a beginning, you know, to something that we got to do more of in the, you know, upcoming legislature.
Senator, you said it made you emotional to think about your son and his childcare. If you don't mind me asking, how come?
Well, it's just really hard to, you know, bring your children to a place like that and drop them off in a place that you know that the people are good and everything. But, you know, you're walking away and depending on somebody else to, you know, take over for, you know, yourself. And I think that that's a real concern for people, whoever they are. And throughout the day, you have to think about that. You have to worry about that. I think that obviously if you're working for somebody, that challenges your productivity. If your mind is, you know, obviously on your children, which is appropriate, but if you could, you know, not have to worry so much about that, you know, I think you'd probably be more productive in your workplace or, you know, whatever your job is. And
feeling confident. And so I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, no, I mean, you're absolutely right. I mean, just knowing that your children in a safe environment, that they're being taught quality educational experience, and you can afford it. You know, I mean, what a burden to take off of, you know, working parents in this society today. And so I just think that's a big deal. I mean, like I said, you know, my wife was working at the time. I was going back to school. You know, I mean, she had obviously a lot more of the burden than I did, but, you know, dropping your children off is a hard thing. I mean, it really is. And so knowing that they're in a good setting, a safe setting, a place that they're learning, you know, more than ever, I think is just really something that is awesome to do for.
You know, Senator, I remember I used to be a after school teacher, a camp counselor. It was not it was day camp, you know, so we weren't overnight or anything. It was kids, you know, ages 3 to 12. But I remember that they, you know, my boss said to us, hey, you know, these parents are dropping off their kids, trusting you to be mom and dad for the day. I mean, it's a big responsibility. Yeah. So anyway, I connect with you on that. And now that I've got a 15-month-old, I
yeah, congratulations.
Thank you.
That really is. I mean, that's a huge responsibility. Not something that every person. I don't think I could do that. And not something there. And that's why I say this EduCare model puts more in. So appropriate and important. I think advancing our children, like you said, take, you know, a small part of parenting, or not small part, a large part, but, you know, they're not becoming the parent, but they're certainly being a surrogate, and that's really important.
Are there any, and this is my last question, unfortunately, because I have to get going to my next thing, but I wanted to ask you, there was part of the bill includes potentially adding 5 more locations.
Yeah.
Those would be the hubs of that hub and spoke model, right? Do we know where those would be right now? What county?
No, I mean,
I got it all worked out.
Yeah, there's people. Okay. I mean, there's obviously people that are going to have to apply for that. The department's going to have to come up with rulemaking, but, you know, different areas of the state that, you know, actually apply, that have put things in place that makes it appropriate after that rulemaking, you know, then they'll be selected if they do qualify. But it's, you know, important. Like our original bill 2 years ago was more. The department was against it for the cost, so we pared it down. Like I said, I am nowhere near, I don't feel like we've accomplished everything at this point. We need to do more.
Gotcha. Senator, I appreciate your time. Christine, thanks for setting us up. I'll be in touch with Christine and
yeah,
I'll let you know when this is going to be on. Thank you, Senator.
Okay, take care.
Take care. Bye.